In the ancient kingdom of Macedonia, a remarkable chapter in history unfolded with the birth of a prince named Alexander. Today, we share the extraordinary journey of Alexander the Great. On the 20th of July, in the year 356 BC, in the capital city of Pella, Alexander came into the world. He was the son of King Philip II and Olympias, destined for a unique and illustrious future. Long ago, before Alexander's birth, his mother, Olympias, had a prophetic dream. A thunderbolt struck her womb, and a flame spread far and wide, foretelling the greatness of the child yet to be born. Raised with care by his nurse, Laenike, and guided by the wisdom of relatives, such as Leonidas and Lysimachus, Alexander's early years were filled with lessons befitting a noble Macedonian prince. When he was just a kid, Alexander met a wild horse named Bucephalus. Even though the horse was a bit scared, Alexander showed courage and tamed him. They became best friends. When he got a bit older, Alexander had a super smart teacher named Aristotle. They studied in a special place called the Temple of the Nymphs, where Alexander learned about lots of interesting things. At the tender age of 16, fate's call echoed through the Macedonian hills. A Thracian revolt threatened the peace, and Alexander, still under the tutelage of Aristotle, was entrusted with a monumental task. King Philip II, Alexander's father, recognized the strategic brilliance within his son. With a solemn charge, he tasked Alexander to quell the Thracian revolt and safeguard Macedonia. The battlegrounds transformed into a realm of opportunity. Alexander not only triumphed over the Thracian rebellion, but in a stroke of visionary genius, founded a city a testament to his leadership and foresight. Alexandropolis rose, a symbol of resilience, strategic prowess, and the indomitable spirit of Alexander. In the year 336 BC, a pivotal moment unfolded in the ancient kingdom of Macedonia. The young Alexander, only 20 years old, stood at the crossroads of fate. Tragedy struck when Alexander's father, King Philip, was assassinated by his own bodyguard, Pausanias. In the wake of this shocking event, a determined Alexander stepped forward to claim the Macedonian throne. With a swift and decisive move, Alexander ensured his sovereignty by eliminating rivals who sought to challenge his ascent. With his domestic affairs in order, Alexander set his sights on a grander ambition, continuing Macedonia's world domination. The echoes of his father's conquests reverberated in Alexander's mind. He readied his army for a journey to Persia, the next frontier in the Macedonian quest for supremacy. The journey began as they crossed the narrow strait known as the Hellespont, a gateway between the Aegean Sea and the Sea of Marmara. At the Granicus River, Alexander faced Persian and Greek forces. The clash was fierce, but victory ultimately smiled upon the Macedonians, solidifying their reputation as formidable conquerors. Moving south, the city of Sardes fell easily to Alexander's advancing army. His momentum, however, met resistance in the cities of Miletus, Mylasa, and Halicarnassus. Halicarnassus, under siege but refusing to yield, stood as a beacon of resilience. Continuing his grand journey, Alexander and his brave army left the city of Halicarnassus and headed north to a place called Gordium. Gordium was famous for something special, the Gordian Knot. It wasn't just any knot. It was a mysterious tangle of tightly woven ropes tied to an ancient wagon. People believed a magical prophecy. Whoever could unravel the Gordian knot would conquer all of Asia. It was like a big challenge waiting for a hero. Now, Alexander was up for the challenge. He tried to untie the knot with his hands, but it was so tricky that he couldn't make it budge. Being the clever thinker he was, Alexander decided to take a different approach. He took out his sword and, with a swift stroke, sliced right through the knot. The people gasped in amazement. Alexander had found a clever way to conquer the knot and claim triumph. It was like he unlocked a secret door to success. With the Gordian knot behind him, Alexander continued his journey, leaving behind a tale of ingenuity that echoed through the lands. Year 333 BC, the great Alexander and his brave warriors found themselves face to face with a massive Persian army led by King Darius III. The stage for the Battle of Issus was set near the town of Issus in southern Turkey. Alexander's forces were outnumbered, but they had something more powerful: experience, determination for revenge, and a hunger to claim the great wealth of Persia, much of it plundered. The clash was fierce, with swords clashing and arrows filling the air. Even though Alexander's men were outnumbered, their skill and determination shone brightly. As the Battle of Issus unfolded, it became clear that Alexander's strategy and resolve would lead to victory. In the face of impending defeat, King Darius fled with the remnants of his troops, leaving his wife and family behind. Darius' mother, Sisygambis, was so upset by her son's actions that she disowned him. In a surprising turn of events, she adopted Alexander as her new son. It was becoming evident that Alexander was not just a conqueror, but a shrewd, ruthless, and brilliant military leader. By this point, he had never lost a battle in his life. Alexander's motto echoed through the lands, "There is nothing impossible to him who will try." With this indomitable spirit, he was set to build an empire that would leave an indelible mark on history. Undeterred by another rejected peace offer from Darius, Alexander set his sights on Egypt, a land of mystery and ancient wonders. His path to Egypt faced a significant obstacle at Gaza, where he encountered resistance and endured yet another lengthy siege. Weeks later, Alexander emerged victorious and continued his march into the heart of Egypt. In Egypt, Alexander founded a city that would stand the test of time: Alexandria. A testament to his vision and ambition, the city still bears his name to this day. Intrigued by the mystical allure of the desert, Alexander embarked on a journey to consult the Oracle of Ammon, a god known for offering wise counsel. Legends abound about the encounter, but Alexander chose to keep the details shrouded in mystery. The oracle's secrets became a topic of speculation, fueling whispers that Alexander might be more than just a mortal. The enigma surrounding the visit only deepened the mystery of his divine connection. In the year 331 BC, the great clash between Alexander and Darius reached its pinnacle at the Battle of Gaugamela. After fierce fighting and heavy losses on both sides, Darius faced defeat and fled, meeting a tragic end at the hands of his own troops. In a poignant moment, Alexander, upon finding Darius's lifeless body, felt a sense of sadness. Despite the rivalry, he honored his fallen adversary with a royal burial. With Darius out of the picture, Alexander seized the opportunity and proclaimed himself the rightful king of Persia, marking a pivotal moment in his conquest. However, another challenger emerged: Bessus, believed to be Darius's murderer, also laid claim to the Persian throne. Alexander could not let this challenge go unanswered. Relentless in his pursuit, Alexander chased Bessus, who had taken refuge with his troops. The relentless pursuit finally led to Bessus's capture. Bessus faced the consequences of his actions when his own troops handed him over to Ptolemy, a close friend of Alexander. In a grim end, Bessus was mutilated and executed. With Bessus removed, Alexander secured full control of Persia, solidifying his dominance over the vast empire. He embraced Persian customs, donning their attire and adopting practices like proskynes, a court custom involving bowing down and kissing hands based on rank. The attempt to be seen as a deity, especially through proskynes, did not sit well with his loyal followers. The Macedonians, proud of their own traditions, were less than thrilled with Alexander's transformations. Refusing to bow down in proskynes, some even harbored thoughts of plotting against their once beloved leader. As paranoia gripped Alexander, he took a drastic step. In 330 BC, he ordered the execution of one of his most esteemed generals, Parmenio. The reason? Parmenio's son, Philotas, had been convicted of plotting an assassination attempt against Alexander and met a tragic end. The year 328 BC marked a tumultuous chapter in Alexander's life. Cleitus, a trusted general and close friend, met a violent end. Frustrated with Alexander's evolving persona, a drunken Cleitus relentlessly insulted him, diminishing his achievements. Pushed to the edge, Alexander, in a fit of anguish, killed Cleitus with a spear, a moment that haunted him deeply. In 327 BC, the indomitable Alexander set his sights on Punjab, India. His journey brought encounters with diverse tribes. Some surrendered peacefully, while others resisted. In 326 BC, the Hydaspes River witnessed a fierce clash between Alexander and King Porus of Parava. Porus, though less experienced, possessed a formidable force, including elephants. After a brutal battle in a raging thunderstorm, Porus was defeated. Amid the triumphs, tragedy struck at Hydaspes, the death of Alexander's beloved horse, Bucephalus. Whether from battle wounds or old age, the loss devastated Alexander, leading him to name a city in honor of his loyal companion. Determined to conquer all of India, Alexander faced resistance from his war-weary soldiers. Their refusal and the counsel of his officers led him to abandon the grand ambition, choosing to return to Persia. Alexander, wounded in battle with the Mali, embarked on a journey down the Indus River. His forces, divided, faced challenges and hardships as they navigated the treacherous terrain. In the early days of 324 BC, Alexander reached the city of Susa in Persia, a pivotal moment that would shape the course of his legacy. With a vision of uniting the Persians and Macedonians, Alexander devised a bold plan. He ordered a mass wedding, where many of his officers married Persian princesses, aiming to create a new race loyal solely to him. However, this attempt at cultural blending did not sit well with the Macedonian army. Resentment brewed, and many mutinied against Alexander's vision of change. Undeterred, Alexander took a firm stand. He replaced Macedonian officers and troops with Persians, sending a clear message about his commitment to the unity he envisioned. To ease tensions, Alexander returned titles to his army and hosted a grand reconciliation banquet. The celebration marked a turning point, fostering a renewed sense of unity and loyalty. The echoes of change and reconciliation resonated through the ranks. By the year 323 BC, Alexander stood at the helm of an immense empire, but the shadows of loss loomed large. The devastating loss of his friend and reputed lover Hephaestion had left Alexander in mourning. Yet, his unyielding ambition pressed on. With an insatiable desire for world supremacy, Alexander set his sights on conquering Arabia. Plans were laid, but fate had a different script. In June 323 BC, after surviving numerous battles, Alexander the Great succumbed to an untimely death at the age of 32. The exact cause remains shrouded in mystery, with debates ranging from natural causes like malaria to speculations of poisoning. Alexander, in his passing, left behind a void. With no named successor, the empire he fought fiercely to create plunged into chaos. Bloody infighting for control shattered the unity he had strived to achieve. The legacy of Alexander the Great endured, but the empire he envisioned crumbled in the wake of his demise. The epithet Great bestowed upon Alexander is not just a historical title, it's a testament to the enduring impact he left on the ancient world. Many lands that fell under Alexander's conquest retained the indelible mark of Greek influence. The cities he founded became cultural hubs, fostering a lasting legacy that echoes through the ages. The era from Alexander's death to 31 BC is known as the Hellenistic period. The term derives from Hellazine, meaning to speak Greek or identify with the Greeks. During this time, the influence of Greek culture and language spread far and wide. Alexander the Great stands as a revered figure, one of the most powerful and influential leaders of the ancient world. His vision, conquests, and the empire he shaped left an indelible mark on history. As we navigate through the annals of history, the greatness of Alexander lies not just in the vast territories he conquered, but in the enduring legacy of Greek culture that he propagated. Thanks for watching our exploration of Alexander the Great's life. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave your feedback in the comments below, subscribe for more historical content, and share this video with your friends who love history. Together, let's keep the spirit of greatness alive.